Hi everybody! Newton's method is a very handy iterative algorithm for finding the zeros of mathematical functions, such as the square root of any given number, which will be our example in this video. By the end of this video, you will understand how the algorithm works and how to implement it in Python. So in Newton's method, you first need an initial estimate that is then iteratively improved. In this video, we will call the initial estimate E sub 0. The quality of the initial estimate doesn't really matter for our purpose, so we will simply use the number itself as the estimate. In other words, we will set E sub 0 to be equal to the number x, whose square root we are trying to calculate. Then, we use Newton's formula, which is the core of the whole algorithm, to calculate a better estimate E sub 1 from a given E sub 0. We can generalize this so that we calculate from a given E sub I a new E sub I plus 1, which is a better estimate than E sub I. This is precisely what makes the algorithm iterative, because we can run it for as long as we need to achieve the desired precision of the result. In our case, we will stop the algorithm when we reach the maximum precision that Python's float type can hold. Now, we have to explain what the function f is. Do you remember in the beginning I said that Newton's method is a way of finding the zeros of mathematical functions? With that in mind, we can specialize the formula for roots, as you can see on the left now. The point of this function f is that it is equal to 0 if and only if e sub I is equal to the square root of x. The last missing piece to explain before we can start writing the code is the function f prime. The single quote means first derivative, but it's not as scary as it may seem at first. At least in this case, there's a simple mapping that we can apply to the function f to derive the function f prime from it. How this works exactly is out of scope for this video, but in a nutshell, you take the exponent in f, make a factor out of it, and then reduce the exponent by 1. Anyways, when we do just that, we get the function f prime that you can see on the left now. If we now take all the pieces and put them together, we get the complete formula for square roots. And to get the formula for cube roots, we simply have to substitute the 2 in the formula with a 3. Or even better, we can substitute the 3 with a n to get the generic formula for n roots. And with that, we finally have everything that we need to implement Newton's method for n roots in Python. To start off with the implementation, we are defining three functions for the square root, the cube root, and the n root. All of the three functions take an argument x, which is the number whose root should be calculated, and they also all return a float, which is the root that has been calculated. There's no actual implementation for square root and n root, because these two functions will simply delegate to the n root function. To do so, they pass along their x argument that they receive to nroot, and they also add another argument n that tells nroot which root exactly has to be calculated. I'm also adding a couple of test cases, one for the square root and one for the cube root, to test the correctness of the calculated root for a few basic cases. Note that I'm also using PyTest's approximation function to avoid assertion errors due to rounding errors that are inherent in the float type. Now we can finally get into the implementation of the formula that we developed before. As I already said, our initial estimate will be the number x whose square root we are calculating. Next, we need a loop, and in the loop we are going to use our formula to calculate the next estimate from the current estimate. At this point, I am pretty much one-to-one translating the formula to Python code. For readability, I'm using separate variables for the numerator and denominator in the formula. Lastly, I'm getting everything ready for the next iteration of the loop by assigning the current estimate to the previous estimate and the next estimate to the current estimate variables. If we were to leave it like this, it wouldn't work at all, because our function would never get out of the loop and therefore never return. In other words, we need an exit condition for the loop. In the beginning, I said that we would calculate our roots up to the maximum precision that Python's float type can hold. This is the case when the next estimate is either equal to the current estimate or the previous estimate. Simply comparing the next estimate to the current estimate would not be enough due to the imprecision and rounding errors that can and do happen whenever you work with floating point numbers. At this point, we are done with our implementation, but I'm adding a few more randomized tests to be 100% sure. That's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you did, please consider leaving a like. Thank you, and see you next time.